Welcome to this session on graph-based RAG knowledge graph creation. Today we will discuss how SAP HANA Cloud powers enterprise-grade retrieval augmented generation by creating robust knowledge graphs. This approach grounds large language models and domain knowledge, improving accuracy, reducing hallucinations, and making AI more explainable and auditable. This guide follows SAP-specific technologies and implementation steps. Everything here is rooted in current SAP HANA Cloud capabilities. In this session, we'll first provide an overview of knowledge graphs, their use in retrieval augmented generation. Then we will look into what is needed to enable this in SAP BTP, including technical prerequisites for using the knowledge graph engine in SAP HANA Cloud. After that, we will illustrate the process of creating a knowledge graph from a data set through an example. Finally, we will recommend additional material to expand your knowledge. Large language models are good at understanding and generating text, but they need reliable sources of information to provide correct answers to real business questions. A knowledge graph is a smart way to organize facts and show how everything is connected. It combines data from tables, documents, and even expert knowledge. Using a knowledge graph can help AI to focus on real facts, so it makes fewer mistakes and gives you answers you can trust. Another important point is that it reduces the likelihood of large language models hallucinating, as the context provides help to clearly define the domain of knowledge. By creating a knowledge graph, you'll get a clear and organized view of your data that shows how key concepts are connected. This helps the retrieval generation system find more relevant information and give better answers. The results include more accurate and trustworthy responses, fewer mistakes, and a system that's easier to update and explain. Before you begin, it's helpful to know a few key concepts. Retrieval augmented generation combines a search step with a large language model, finds the relevant information first, then uses it to generate better answers. Knowledge graph is a network of facts made up of entities, things like people or places, and their relationships, otherwise how they're connected. Resource Description Framework, or RDF in short, is a standard way to represent data as triples, subject, predicate, and object. The relationships encoded in triples are easy to understand. Triples are the basic building block of a knowledge graph. In a knowledge graph notation, facts are expressed as triples. A triple has three parts: subject, predicate, object E.G compressor motor A is monitored by vibration sensor X. An ontology describes how the entities in your knowledge graph relate to each other. It's a conceptualization of what these entities and relationships mean in that domain and in the context of the related knowledge graph. A representation of the types of entities, their properties, and the relationships between them. Entity extraction means to pull out important names or terms from the text, like pairs or SAP BP relationship. Extraction is about finding how entities are related. E.G works at foundation by, related at normalization, or the duplication is the process of merging duplicate or similar entities to keep the graph clean and avoid redundancy. For example, IBM, I.B.M, and International Business Machines is one node. Sparkle is a query language for working with RDF data. You use SBA RQL to search, filter, and get information from knowledge graphs built with RDF. Check SAP HANA Cloud Knowledge Graph Engine in SAP HANA Database before you start building your knowledge graph powered retrieval augmented generation. You'll need the right SAP landscape in place. First, make sure you have access to SAP BTP, the foundational platform connecting all SAP AI data and development services. Then provision SAP HANA Cloud. This is your core database for storing and querying both business data and knowledge graphs. Activate the Knowledge Graph Engine for semantic modeling and rich entity relationships, and the Vector Engine for a similarity search. SAP AI Core is your engine for orchestrating and scaling AI model pipelines. It integrates with SAP apps and automates retaining or extraction jobs. SAP AI Launchpad is where you register your AI scenarios, manage model deployments, and oversee the full lifecycle of your AI assets. Setting up these prerequisites is the first step to ensuring your retrieval augmented generation implementation is secure, scalable, and ready for enterprise workloads on SAP. Let's look at how all the SAP components come together for knowledge graph-powered retrieval augmented generation on SAP BTP. End users access the application through a secure HTTPS channel. The requests pass through the SAP BTP subaccount, starting with authentication and trust management using BTP Native Identity and Authorization Services. The application logic sits inside of SAS or Cloud Foundry services connected to the rest of the SAP landscape. At the heart of this architecture is SAP HANA Cloud. Here, your data is managed and analyzed using three native engines: the Vector Engine for similarity search and embeddings, the Knowledge Graph Engine for semantic relationships and reasoning, and Classic Predicate Analysis Library and Automated Predicate Library for advanced analytics, and full SBRQL support for complex graph queries. The Generative AI Hub, which includes SAP AI, Launchpad, and AI Core, provides the orchestration layer for your AI scenarios. It enables secure, governed access to both SAP-built and partner-built functional models like Azure OpenAI and Anthropic, while offering robust guardrails such as access control, auditability, and prompt grounding. This architecture means enterprise context always flows from SAP HANA Cloud to your generative AI models, making every response explainable and grounded in trusted business data. With all communications managed through SAP BTP Trust Managed Network, you'll get the best of both worlds: enterprise-grade security and compliance. With the flexibility to use the latest generative AI knowledge graph technologies, this approach ensures you can innovate with AI while staying fully aligned to SAP standards for trust, security, and data governance. This best practice is about creating a knowledge graph from a data set. It can be, for example, a PDF file. Here are the process steps. First, define ontology. This is optional. Second, design the prompts. Third, create extraction workflows. Fourth, review extracted triples. Five, store the knowledge graph. In the following, we will describe the use case, prerequisites, and recommendations for completing the above steps. Let's start with the use case. This example shows how a company can use large equipment specification documents, such as PDFs about individual industrial motors, to build a knowledge graph. The goal is to extract clear facts about things like power, voltage, and manufacturer for each motor and create a knowledge graph based on this information. This can help the company answer questions about the equipment quickly, find important parts, and organize its data well for reporting or maintenance. The example code takes these real-world documents, extracts the facts, and loads them into a knowledge graph that anyone in the company can search or use for business purposes. Let's now look into each step of the process. Step one is about defining the ontology. An ontology is a structured definition of the key entity types, their properties, and the relationships between them and your business domain. It helps clarify what is most important for reporting and analysis. Defining an ontology is optional, but highly recommended if you want your knowledge graph to deliver consistent and business-relevant results. To get started, simply list the most important properties and types. This can be a simple spreadsheet. This approach will improve the quality of the information you extract and help your team focus on what matters. For more complex scenarios, you can formalize your ontology as a knowledge graph in SAP HANA Cloud. This makes it easier to maintain, extend, and reuse the ontology across projects and enables integration with advanced analytics or AI analysis. Whether you start simple or go further, having a clear ontology ensures that you always extract facts that matter to your business, making automation more reliable and transparent. The second step is to design a prompt. We make explicit what labels, relationships, and structures the LLM must follow. We establish rules for labeling, naming, and identification. We also define what relationships are permitted, as well as the expected data format. We specify the property format and naming, and include a real-world example to create the extraction workflows. We import the required libraries, load environmental variables related to API keys and database credentials, and create triples based upon text from a PDF file. The next practical question is how to turn real documents into knowledge graph triples. We download a PDF file, extract its content, and concatenate all pages into a single string. Then we use the prompt from step one with a large language model via AI Core to extract the triples from this content. In this scenario, we are working with a small document, so it's feasible to provide the entire text as context to the LLM. As modern language models now support long context windows, for most use cases, this approach is sufficient. However, for edge cases where documents exceed the maximum context window, we recommend splitting the document into smaller sections and processing each part sequentially. On the screen, you see what the code for the extraction process looks like. Please note the setting temperature equal to zero. This is important so that the LLM strictly follows the prompt without any variation. Let's quickly check the logic of the triples before loading them into SAP HANA. Early errors are easy to fix, but errors in the database are harder to debug. We will put the extracted triples to the console so that the main expert can inspect the data for obvious problems or inconsistencies. If anything seems strange or incorrect, such as missing data, incorrect relationships, or unexpected values, you can stop the process and fix it immediately. Then go back and refresh the prompt, make the changes, and rear-end the triples for extraction. Take a few minutes to ensure that the resulting knowledge graph is accurate, usable, and ready for your business needs. After you've checked the triples, save them in the database so you and your team can use them later. To do this, we load all validated triples into SAP HANA Cloud, which support graph data. When storing triples in an RDF knowledge graph, each entity in a relationship in an RDF knowledge graph is represented by a so-called IRI, which stands for Internationalized Resource Identifier. An IRI ensures that each object in the graph has a unique standard name that will work in databases and on the web. For literals, such as names or numbers, all special characters must be escaped so that the data is not corrupted when stored. This is why helper functions are needed before inserting triples, otherwise the data may not load or cause errors later. First, for each triple subjects and predicates, and objects that are represented, entities are converted to iris using IRI, while values, such as numbers or text, are treated as literals with appropriate escaping via two literals to prevent formatting errors. After the transformation, the SAP HANA SPA RQL execute procedure is used to store the extracted triples as a knowledge graph in HANA. SAP HANA's Knowledge Graph engine comprises a HANA triple store for storing RDF data and a SQL RQL query engine for querying the graph. Storing your data this way allows you to run advanced SQL RQL queries and integrate knowledge graph results with other SAP tools and business processes. The snippet connects to SAP HANA using environment variables for security. It creates an IRI for the knowledge subjects and predicates and formats each object as either an IRI if it represents an entity or as a literal if it's a value like text or a number. Then for each triple, it creates and executes a SparkQL execute statement in bulk mode. The last step is useful for checking that the knowledge graph is saved correctly in HANA Cloud and for quickly obtaining insights before using the data in business applications. After loading the triples into SAP HANA, you can run SQL ARQL queries to validate and analyze the data. In this example, the query counts how many times each property appears in the graph. The script uses SparkQL table to execute the query and outputs the results so that you can verify the correctness of the data. If you want to expand your knowledge, visit the graph-based RAG Knowledge Graph Creation Best Practice page, and you'll find several learning journeys available. An additional material about SparkQL syntax and SAP HANA Cloud creation of knowledge graphs and knowledge use cases. This best practice guide reflects the collective expertise of AI specialists from across SAP, bringing together insights to support your journey. Thank you for watching the session. We hope the information provided helps you successfully implement advanced generative AI capabilities in your business applications.